Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samanitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhu Bande Nitta Nanda Sahoditam Si Nanda 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 Bande Radhika Charana Dayam Gopiyana Samayuktam Binda Vāñśā kalpataru vyaśyakipāsin sindhu bevacu patitānaṁ pāpune bhavishnabhyo namo namo mukhaṁ karoti vācālaṁ paṅgum laṅhatagiram yatkipātamahaṁ bandhi paramānandamādavam brindāvai tulsidevvai piyāvai kesavasacu Krishna Bhakti Pade Devi Sattva Bhattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Narancaiva Narottama Devim Swaraswati Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukto Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagodaranya Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtadoham Tithas Padam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam Vitatiham Panotapal Bhavadibhutam Bande Mahapurusate Charuna Ravindam Yat Pada Pallavanakachandamani Chataya Bispurjita Kamabhikabo Dushva Darshi Purna Nuragara Sasagara Saramurti Saradhikamai Kadakivam Karush Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajānulambita bhujau kanaka budhato Sankitanoika pitaru kamala yatakshu Vishambaru dijavaru jugadharma paru Bande jagat priyakaru karuna bhaktaru Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare, Hare. Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam, Sura Surair Vandito Dibha Rupa. Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam bhavanurupe na sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalabam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyam anangam adapuharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavi Shanatham Vagi Shajusho Badane Lakshmi Rujasacha Vakshashi Jasyasthi Hide Sambhid Vam Nishingamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram राम हरे हरे। मोतीर्ण किशने परतो शतो वा मिथो विपदे तो गृहो प्रधानम आदांत गोभीर विशताम तमीशम पुनः पुनः चोर्वितो चार्वनानम। मोतीर्ण किशने परतो शतो वा मिथो विपदे तो गृहो व्रतानम आदांत गोभीर विशताम तमीशम पुनः पुनः चर्वितो चार्वनानम। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगतगुरु टोल्ड अ मैन मे बी बिग पंडित मेटेरियली सो मेनी डिग्रीज देयर विथ हिम ही कैन बी बिग पंडित वट एवर बिग पंडित कैन बी देयर विथ दैट मैन until and unless he is going to prove 100% submission unto the lotus feet of that Tatha Guru, he cannot understand about the topics of Vaishnava Darshan. Whatever panditya can be there with a man, or maybe his thinking power is very high, Manishi is very excellent, his oratorship is very good, maybe is a big scholar, still until and unless he is going to show 100% submission unto the lotus feet of a great Vaishnava whose life is applied form of all Vaishnava Darshan. You can find in the life of Prabhupada, all Gauriya Darshan you can find in applied form. Prabhupada speaking, somebody think Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj is not educated. But Prabhupada speaking, you can find all Vaishnava Darshan Vichar, all the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in applied form in the life of my Guru Pad Padma Paramahansa Sreshtha Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. So common people, their conception is totally wrong. They are thinking about something which is impractical. Until and unless those big pandit or scholars can prove their 100% submission unto lotus feet of Sadguru Padma, I mean Tattvabhid Purush, till then they cannot understand anything about Vaishnava Darshan Vichar. They cannot understand. Because the sloka we know in Gita, Tad Vidhi Panipateno Paripashneno Sevaya Upadekshanti Te Jnanam Jnanena Stattva Darshinaha Tattva Vadi Tattva Darshinaha is, they are actually feeling the Tattva, they can see the Tattva. They can meet with Tattva, what they are speaking. But those who are Tattva Badi, mean they just memorize. They can speak in front of public to get clapping. So, Tattva Badi Purush, their realization is not positive, not practical. But if we can fulfill this condition, Prabhupada speaking, unconditional surrender, first point, second point, honest inquiry, not to see that that Vaishnava, that Guru, how far, how much he is going to know. Let me test. This kind of testing can make you fall down. You cannot do it. Unconditional surrender first, honest inquiry, second, and the serving temper. If there is three qualities there in a so-called devotee, surely he can get Tattva Gyan from is Acharya. Acharya, you will have to approach with Samitupanim Sautiyam Brahmanishtam. You will have to approach with wooden piece. Because the fire sacrifice is going to take place, they will have to, as oblation, you will have to give sacrifice, you will have to give wooden piece. Wooden piece actually means you will have to give yourself. Actually, you will have to give your all, you know, liberty unto the lotus feet of Sadguru Dev. It is called Samit Pani Sautiyam. You have to carry and you have to give Dakshina. Dakshina, without Dakshina, you cannot get Dibha Gyan. You have to approach. In that case, the big, big acharyas of Vaishnava Darshan, those who are great sadhus of Vaishnava Darshan, they can surely advise you, give you advice about Vaishnava Darshan, because they are less interested about material benefit. They are not feeling any kind of attraction for appliances visible in this material world. They are less interested. They are always looking inside. They are not looking outside. Outside, those who are foolish, material man, they are looking outside. But pure way, Guru Vaishnava always looking, have inside vision. Their inside vision is so pure, so high, so accurate, that even we cannot imagine. These three conditions should be fulfilled. Unconditional surrender, honest inquiry, and serving temper. If we like to stay peacefully without seva, seva means problem again, you will have to learn. It is good to learn something else, language. If we learn computer, then Maharaj can give some seva, it's a big headache. No need actually. Why should we do so much trouble? Body has some value and money has some value. This is the conception of materially inspired people. Those who are materially inspired, they are always thinking about material benefit. Or better we can see. Somebody speaking, Maharaj, we must do Ekadashi because Ekadashi can make our health very good. Ekadashi fasting is very good for health. Those were idiot people, they are thinking that way. Follow. But our Ekadashi is to get bhakti, not to make our health proper. This is not the mood of a seva. Follow. I can learn such a thing so that my body can become very fit. At the same time, say energy can, calorie can, I can spend. Because anyway, I'm sitting, doing, so body movement needs, so I can do this seva. But they are not going to take trouble. For the actual seva, they should, you know, do. They are not going to take. They are not going to ready. They are not ready to do it. If we learn, then so many seva can come, whole day and night we have to do. Well, who can take trouble? It's good, relax. Prabhupada speaking, avoiding seva, those who like to stay very peacefully, they are actually material man. They have no idea about bhajan line. Yesterday also I was speaking heavily to give inspiration about seva. Not to criticize anybody. It's a fact. The more you can feel attraction for seva, the more you can realize Vaishnava Tattva. Otherwise, unnecessarily, some ambiguity can be there, fighting mood. You know, unnecessary suspicion, doubt can contaminate. Without seva, if somebody like to stay peacefully, is it good? Prabhupada said, no, not at all. To stay peacefully without any trouble is the mood of a non-devotee, Prabhupada speaking. Some Brajavasi giving some seva, one Giridhari is there, and nothing. chapati already coming, sabji from Bajivasa, some laddu vaddu. Who takes trouble to cook at that? We can say in Govardhan, a very nice, sometime in relaxed mood, I can go to do parikram. No trouble, no headache. This is the thing, they think this is bhajan. They think this is bhajan. At the bank of Manasiganga, I can say, and one giridhari of one bhajan, okay, no problem. It takes half an hour, after that I can relax. And chapati, already chapati coming. And if I get time, sometime in relaxed mood, I can go to do parikram. But that was not the mood of Sanatan. That was not the mood of Rupa Goswami. That was not the mood of Raghunath Das Goswami, Jiva Goswami. They never wanted to think that way. We cannot cook, we can go for Madhukuri, simply because we like to save our time and take rest. This is the mood. So this is actually the mood of a non-devotee. Those who like to avoid the seva of Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, and like to lead a very peaceful and fine life, peacefully, and very nicely, Sachanda. And this kind of sadhu, so-called sadhu, this kind of so-called devotees, if they are going to ask some seva from somebody, they also like to avoid, because they know he is non-devotee. It's non-devotee, karmi. This way actually, we'll have to be always alert. Kaya, man, bhakka, body, speech and mind. Body, speech and mind, we'll have to, by the help of body, speech and mind, always we'll have to get ready for seva. All the time seva, nothing else. This kind of passive mood is not at all allowed. It's one kind of maya, Simply maya. Everybody can pass lecture on these topics of maya. But if you can realize what is maya, then automatically I can, because I told that day, when I can understand, one ghost going to catch me, I feel something, then the ghost cannot come inside body. Those who can realize the one ghost going to catch me, then the ghost cannot catch. Worry, follow. This way, if you can understand, this is maya. If you are alert all the time, going to maintain your purity, external or internal, external all the time, let me see which ghost can catch you. It is not possible. Another point is that Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving the explanation of maya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to give a nice explanation, definition of maya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, The Sarup Shakti of Bhagavan is actually internal potency, it is all. Except that another Shakti we feel as if there, But without the existence of that internal potency, Sarup Shakti, this Shakti cannot protect her own existence. I mean, without the existence of that Shakti, this Shakti, she cannot prove existence. Like shadow. If you just stand against a light source, you can find a shadow backside. But if the light source is taken away, then the shadow is vanished. Same thing. So, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to explain the Maya Shakti this way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to explain Maya Shakti this way. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Bhagavan internal potency, Antaranga Shakti is the Shakti, Sarup Shakti, internal potency. Except that another Shakti, as if there is another Shakti, we feel the existence, as if. But without the existence of the previous Shakti, I mean Sarva Shakti, this Maya Shakti can lose existence. It's called Maya Shakti. About this Maya Shakti, Brahma Sangita clearly speaking, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to explain in a very scientific way. Without the explanation of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, who is going to understand the explanation of Jiva Goswami Pada? That is the main question. That is the main question, who can understand? So Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they are explaining very nice way. And in Bhagavatam, different sloka, we find Jaya Sanmahita Nyagatam, already I told, is actually Maya Shakti. By the magic spell of this Maya, all Jivas, Paro Opi Manate Anartham. Paro Opi, this is outside thing. Is outside thing, nothing, but still. Paro Opi Manate Anartham. It is very nice thing. So Maya has nothing to do with Chidatma. So Maya has nothing to do, whatever, Maya has nothing to do, whatsoever. So Maya has nothing to do with the creation of Sarupa, I mean, with the Sarupa of Jiva, I mean Chid Atma. All Jiva Chit particles of Maya has nothing to do. So is there any connection of Chid Atma, I mean Jiva Shakti, Chit particle, has any connection with Maya? Actually no, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, no. The Chit Shakti is Paripurna Shakti. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, no. Chit Shakti, actually Maya Shakti, nothing to do with Chit Shakti. No. The Chit Shakti is Paripurna Shakti, the complete potency of Sri Krishna. And its manifestation are all eternally perfect substances. The Jiva is not Nitya Siddha. That is the main problem. The Jiva, actually Jiva is not the body, but still we think Jiva body. But Jiva is actually that Atma which is there inside body. We are always thinking about our body and mind and body related thing. The Jiva is not Nitya Siddha. Although when she performs sadhana, she can become sadhan siddha and can enjoy transcendental happiness like the Nitya Siddha Jiva. Nitya Siddhas, eternally perfect beings. Nitya Siddha there. All the four types of Srimati Radhika Sakhis are Nitya Siddha and they are direct expansion, Kaya Buha, expansion of Kaya Buha, Vistar, of the Chit Shakti of Srimati Radharani herself. All the Jivas on the other hand have manifested from Sri Krishna's Jiva Shakti, I mean Tatasa Shakti. The Chit Shakti is Krishna's, the Chit Shakti is Krishna's complete Shakti, whereas Jiva Shakti is his incomplete Shakti. Follow. Jiva Shakti, Chit Shakti is Sri Krishna's complete Shakti. Whereas the Jiva Shakti is his incomplete Shakti. Just as the complete Tattvasa, just as the complete Tattvas are all transformation of the complete potency, simply innumerable atomic conscious jivas are transformation of the incomplete Shakti, I mean Tatastha Shakti. Tatastha Shakti, Jiva Shakti is not complete Shakti. Sri Krishna being established in each of his Shaktis, Sri Krishna being established in each of his Shaktis, manifest his Sarupa according to the nature of the Shakti. The kind of Shakti, the kind of, you know, expression. His Sarup according to the nature of Shakti. Sri Krishna being established in each of his Shaktis, manifest his, you know, Sarupa according to the nature of that Shakti. When he is situated in the Chit Sarupa, he manifests his Sarupa as Sri Krishna and also as Narayana, the Lord of Parabrahma. When he is situated in the Jiva Shakti, he manifests his Sarupa as is Vilasmurti of Braja, the Lord. When he is situated in a Jiva Shakti, he manifests his Sarupa as is Vilasmurti of Braja Baladeva, and being established in the Maya Shakti, he manifests the three Vishnu forms, I mean Karuna Navasai, Kirada Gosai, Garbhada Gosai, etc. In his Krishna form in Braja, he manifests all the spiritual affairs of the superlative degree. In his Baladeva Sarupa as Seva Tatta, he manifests Nitta, Mukta, Parshadas, Parshad Jivas, eternally liberated associates who render eight types of service of Krishna's Seshi Tatta Sarupa. The origin of Shesha Tatta, as the origin of Shesha Tatta, going to do Seva. Again, as Shesha Rupa Sankarsana in Parabrahma, he manifests eight types of seva, servants, sevaks, to render eight kinds of services as eternally liberated associates of Seshi Rupa Narayana. Vaikuntha also there. Mahavishnu, who is an avatara of Sankarsana, Mahavishnu, who is an avatara of Sankarsana, situates himself in the Jiva Shakti, and his Paramatma Sarupa. Jiva Goswami is also right. Paramatma Vaibhav. So, and his Paramatma Vaibhava Sarupa, he manifests the Jivas who have the potential to be involved in the material world. These Jivas are suitable to These jivas are suitable both for chit jagat and material jagat. I mean those jivas are susceptible to the influence of Maya, and unless they attain the shelter of the Ladini Shakti, Sarv Shakti, or the Chit Shakti by Bhagavan's mercy or Bhakta mercy, the possibility of their being defeated by Maya is always there, remains. The countless conditioned jivas who have been conquered by Maya are subordinate to the three modes of material nature, sattva, rajas, tama. Bearing all this in mind, the Siddhanta is that Maya has nothing to do with Chit Shakti. Keeping bearing all in mind, all this tattva, what all I am going to discuss, we should remember that this Siddhanta should be there, that it is only the Jiva Shakti and not Chit Shakti that manifest all the jivas. It's not possible. Only jivas they are going to manifest, not that impossible. Only those jivas. Tata jiva shakti manifested by jiva shakti manifested by tatastha shakti. As no maya shakti has nothing to do. Maya shakti has nothing to do with that. Is the main point. Also, so Maya Shakti we see have nothing to do. So now we should remember another sloka. The sloka I started with is very important. Motir na Krishna Paroto Shatova. This point coming. Ajivatma, by personal efforts or by the efforts of others outside our material personalities, anyhow they cannot understand this paratattva. Matir nakishne parato shatoba. Parato, by external help, external outsider, or by personal efforts also, anyway they cannot understand this paratattva. They cannot understand this paratattva, it's not possible. Matirun Krishna Parato Shatoba Mitho Vipaddedu Gihabhatana Adanto Govir Vishatam Panitamishram. Their sense organ not under their control, their mind is not under their control. Matirun Krishna Parato Shatoba Mitho Vipaddedu Gihabhatanam Adanto Govir Vishatam Tamishram Punaha Punaha Charvito Charvanana. Follow. For infinity period, they are going to chew. They are going to chew the same material enjoyment, but still not going to speak enough of it. Now enough of it, stop it, not speaking. That is the enjoyment of Maya Shakti. Motirna Krishne Parato Shatova Mito Vipade Togiho Vratanam Adanta Govir Vishatam Tamisram Punaha Puna Charvito Charvananam. They are not feeling disgusted. They are feeling okay, very good. Same material enjoyment, same. Janma Hito Nadigihamedi Sukham Hitu Cham Kanduyanena Karayarevo Duksha Duksham. Prahladma speaking. Yan maithunad ghamed sukham hitucham. Like you, if you develop scabies, skin disease in your palm, hand. Doctor speaking, don't try to touch your nail. Be careful. Otherwise, there is every possibility to develop some infection. But when you are sleeping, you are feeling some, you know, you are going to touch that spot with nail. You are rubbing that spot with nail to get satisfaction because you are feeling some problem. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, same material enjoyment they are taking, grihastha enjoyment, all the time, griha medhi sukha, they are getting. But still they are not going to express this kind of mood, that enough of it, not they are going to speak. All the time this kind of thing, whole world, the same thing. They are under the influence of Maya. Only you can watch the, you can very carefully, you can go through the life of a pure Guru Vaishnava, you can find how they are possible. As if they are in some sort of intoxication, you can lock their room, their enjoyment. What? Where from this enjoyment coming? Because they have inside vision. You have inside vision and you have outside vision. Always you like to search something outside to get some pleasure, enjoyment. That is your mood. But pure devotees, they always want to see inside heart. They can get everything. They have a separate world inside their heart. All the time they are feeling that. So me and mind conception, not at all applicable for this material body, gross body, or fine body, subtle body, not at all applicable. This is applicable for the chid atma, the spirit. But nobody understands the atma bari drashtabhya shatabhya nididhyasitabhya. This is because Atma is there inside the body of your daughter or son, you are going to love. If Atma is there, not there, how you can love? So Atma Bahari, in relation to Atma, the whole world going to express some kind of relationship with each other. Atma Bahari, Drashtabha, Satabha, we like to see, we like to feel, we like to hear, we like to everything, we like to eat. We like to enjoy. This is because Atma is there. Atma va are drashtabhya satabhya nididhyasityabhya. We will have to concentrate on this topic about Atma, which you cannot see, which you cannot feel, even after hearing tatha, hearing katha, nayam atma pravachane na labhya, na medhaya na bhuhun na sute na jam eva ishate na labhya, vibhinatate na stonu sama. In Gita also you read many times, I think, na jayate mriyate va kadachit nayam bhutva bhavita vana huyaha ajo nittaha sasatvayam purano nahannate hannamane sariri. The soul is never born, nor dies, nor does it become, nor does it become on end, become only after being born, for it is unborn, eternally present and everlasting and primeval. Even though the body is slain, even though this material body is slain, the soul can never be slain. I already told many times, this Atma is Prakashman Vastu, Atma is Ganamay Vastu, Atma is Nitya Vastu, Chinmay Vastu. All the time I discuss about this point. Prahlad Maharaj in Vishnu Puran going to speak, Prahlad Maharaj in Vishnu Puran going to speak in front of Bhagavan. I mean, going to express this strong grief for us. Something also Prahlad, our Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speaking, but what Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Prahlad in front of Nrisimhadev, Ja priti rabivekanam vishayeshu anapayini tvam anasmarataha swami hrudayat mapasarpatu. Ja priti abivekanam. Those who are not having any consciousness, those who are not at all having any consciousness, ja priti abivekanam. Those who are bonded soul, they are going to express strong affection, priti, for material things and material relation. Ya priti abivekanam vishayeshu anupayini. Non-stop attraction, non-stop attraction, those bonded souls always feeling for material objects or man. Oh. This is the tragedy. Prahlad Maharaj crying and speaking, Prabhu, similar attraction I like to develop for you. Similar attraction, you please, you arrange in my life so that I can get some kind of attraction. Ya priti avivekanam vishayeshu anupayinihi tvam anasmarataha swami hridayat mapasarpatu. This kind of attraction should be there in my life. So that at any condition, I am not going to forget you. You please arrange that situation in my life. You bestow me kripa, that at any condition, pain and pleasure, any condition, I cannot forget you. You please keep me this kind of benediction. Ja priti avivekanam vishayeshu anupayini tvam anasmarataha sha me hrudayat ma apasarpatu. Bishaye je pritiye achoye amaro sei mato priti ho charane tomaro. You can remember this kinda? Bishaye je pritiye achoye amaro sei mato priti ho charane. You can remember the kirtan? No, you cannot. You cannot remember. Because you are not doing, you have no connection with Kirtan. That's why you cannot remember. You cannot remember.
Prabhu tava pado juge morni vedano nahi mangi deho shukho vidya dhano jano nahi mangi sargo yar Moksha nahi mangi, na kori parthona kono bibhutiro lagi. Nijo karma guno deshe je je janmo pai, janme janme jeno tabo namo guno gai. Bishaye je priti ebe achoye amaro sei mato priti ho charone tomaro sei mato priti ho charone tomaro bipade sampade thakta Thaku shamo bhave, dine dine bidhi ho, namero po bhave, dine dine bidhi ho, namero po bhave, pashu pakhi hoye thaki, sarge bani raye, tabo bhakti rahu bhakti, Binodohi daye, tabo bhakti rahu bhakti, binodohi daye. You may understand the meaning of this kirtan. This meaning of the kirtan can touch your heart. Then you can find that you are successful. If this kind of kirtan not going to touch your heart, then you are not successful. For sure you are doing bhajan. All useless. You are not going to follow the principle of Jivedaya. You are not even going to follow the principle of Jivedaya. You become merciless. You are not going to take care of your, you know, wife, husband, you know, this way you become father, mother, you become this way merciless. What tattva can realize, what realization can bring tattva, tattva vigyan. Anyway, same application Prahlad Maharaj is going to speak in front of Nishingadev. Ja priti avivekanam vishayeshu anapayini tvam anasmarataha same hrudayat ma apasarpatu. I like to maintain that kind of same feeling. Any condition, positive or negative, I like to see you, I like to feel you, your kripa, you please bless me that way. Also, you can remember before I was speaking one nice key, nice sloka, that this kind of danger in our life is not actually danger. The kind of danger we are getting in our life is not actually danger. Even to lose money, position, this, that. You know, husband not going to help you or wife not going to help you. This way different kind of negative situation can come. You are being cheated by somebody, you are feeling sorry, you are going to lose money, huge amount of money. This way, you think it is amangal. But it is not actually amangal. The moment you are going to forget Supreme Lord is called actual amangal. Kunti Devi is going to teach us same way. When Bhagavan Sri Krishna is speaking, what happens? Why you are crying? Naturally, all problem over. Now allow me to go. Now all problem over, Kurukshetra Yudha over. You are going to enjoy complete sober unity all over the world. What problem? Kunti Devi is speaking, now actually problem starting. Now actually problem starting. So long, there is no such big problem. We were in forest, everything taken away, all different kind of anxiety problem was there. But actual problem now going to be started. What problem? But now I can forget you. We can forget you. You are going to give all appliances and suffer unity, everything. And now you are going to go away. But we don't want anything. We want you. Follow. There is a conception of a demon and there is a conception of a perfect human being. Arjun going to ask from Supreme Lord that, Prabhu, I want you. Duryodhan going to want 18 Akshahini. Ka, big amount of soldiers. Number of soldiers. 18 Akshahini. Big amount of soldiers. But Arjun speaking of, Prabhu, I only want you. So their devotee, their conception is totally different. And those are demon, their conception totally different. Vipado naiva vipado, sampado naiva sampado. Vipado visvaranam Vishnu, sampado narayana sriti. Vipado visvaranam Vishnu, sampado narayana sriti. So, vipado naiva vipado. You are thinking it is big problem, Maharaj. In my life, great problem. My health is very bad. What happens? Anyway, we are going to leave body. Vipado naiva vipado. Sampado naiva. You are thinking, now good days. I am getting huge amount of money from my relative, this, that. Now I can keep this money. And you can lead my life very peacefully. Oh, I can prove that I am a great devotee. Who is devotee, who is not? It depends upon the mood of service. Those who are exalted devotees, they can arrest. Any falsity there, they can arrest immediately. So vipado naiva vipado, sampado naiva sampado, vipadaho visvaranam Vishnu, sampado narayana sriti. It is a good time. It is auspicious time. It is called Mangal. If we can remember the lotus feet of Vishnu, I mean Krishna. In the deep darkness of avidya, sarup branta jiva, those who are misled by maya, try to understand. In the deep darkness of avidya, sarup branta, those who cannot understand their actual sarup, sarup vibranta jiva, already have grown a strong bondage of attraction for the material body and body related things to develop me and my conception in this material world. So life after life, they are traveling with this false ego and false conception of material enjoyment, never going to think, never going to think about the real health, never going to think about the real chit-sastha, chit-sastha, health, chit-health. Prabhupada speaking chit-health, I mean they are never going to think about the real sastha, chit-sastha, real health of the chit-atma. That is why jivatma is so weak, so weak and full of dissatisfaction. Full of dissatisfaction all the time. Life after life getting material enjoyment, but still today not getting any saturated point. Actually not possible. How possible? And according to karmaphal, they are running, traveling all around. Kabu sarge, kabu nirae. Sometime going to heaven, sometime going to hell. Sometime this brahmanda here and there. So, brahmanda brahmitya karma, brahmanda brahmitya kuno bhagyavan jeev, guru krishna prasade pai bhakti lata bij. By the mercy of Guru Vishnu, by chance they can get. So karma, according to karma, karma is literally anadi. And how about this Bhaktivinoda speaking? The prime cause of all karma is the desire to execute such karma. Avidya or ignorance is the root cause of this material desire to do something, get something, and is defined as forgetfulness of this truth, absolute truth. They cannot remember of that absolute truth. What is that truth? That I am the eternal servitor of the Supreme Lord. Is going to forget. This avidya, ignorant, did not suddenly sprout out within the time span of material universal creation. The seed of this root of karma originates in the matrix of the tatastha position of the jiva. At the junction of material and spiritual creation, in between this tatastha position. Since the source of karma is thus untraceable within the mundane time of material world, so karma is called anadi. This way actually, anadi karma phale, in kirtan, you can go through kirtan. You go through kirtan to realize this point. Anadi karma phale, pari bhavar navajale, taribare nadekhi upaye. E bishaya hala hale, divanishi hiya jale, monokobu sukho nahi paye. Monokobu sukho nahi paye. This way you will have to do kirtan. Always and every time you will have to do kirtan to realize all this point, you know, feel. is a big problem. Otherwise, nobody can understand. All diversity there, countless diversity is there. Advaita Gyan Tattva is the main objective. We are in confusion, we are going to find diversity all the time. So, we must be very careful before passing any remark about Aprakita Sutra, Bichar. So you must be very careful before passing any remark about Aprakita Shastra Bichar. Now my point is that if at all Supreme Lord, I mean the Sri Krishna, Nandananda Sri Krishna, is Advaita Gyan Tattva, then all countless diversity expressed by him, either in this material world or there in the transcendental world, surely can come under this category of Advaita Gyan Tattva. So what I mean to say, now my point is that if at all Supreme Lord Sri Krishna is Advaita Gyan Tattva, Padanti Tattva Vidam Sattam Yad Jnana Advayam Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavan Iti Sattati. So Bhagavan is Advaita Gyan Tattva. Then all countless diversity expressed by him, either in this material world or maybe there in that transcendental world, surely can come under this Advaita Gyan Tattva. No doubt in it. The Supreme Lord, is always going to express sportive mood, infinite diversity, the mood of bhajan also diversity, countless jivas. That's why yesterday I was discussing countless chit-murti coming from the body effulgence of Bhagavan resting there in Golok Vrindavan. Each jivatma, they have their sarup there waiting. Follow. He who is all-powerful and omnipresent, everything is possible for him. We should not express any doubt about it. All material conceptions about beginning, middle or end, we know the Dham was created by Balaji Maharaj. Sahasvattam kamalam kukulaksham matpadam tat karunikaram tat anantansha sambhava. If Dham is coming from Ananta, then our question is first Dham or first Krishna? His question is absolutely useless. Though starting, middle, end we can find. But our conception is full of contamination. We cannot touch that reality. What is that? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that's why I told. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told in the form of Raghunath Das Baba, saying, my son, better you stop your argument and go on concentrating in bhajan. The more you can go in chit bhavana, chit meditation, the more you can get absorbed in chit meditation, the more you can get realization about it. External material factor, time factors, everything, possibility or non-possibility, or cannot stand, you cannot understand. And you can express again and again doubts, and also you can fall down. So all material conceptions about beginning, middle or end point of any action or leela is not at all applicable there in that transcendental world, where eternal present tense, where eternal present time factors is always effective. Now, if you forcefully try to show any beginning there in the transcendental abode with the help of the case of Gopakumar or any sadhan siddha jiva, then this become impractical. Why? It's become impractical. Any sadhan siddha now going to enter, so he can note a time factor from then onward, not. Bhaktivinoda already told, as soon as Gopakumar going to enter, then his eternal time period, eternity gets satisfied. This example is not 100%, but what to do? I told you one drop of Ganga water, if you throw into Ganges, he cannot, it's become Ganga. So eternal time factor, flowing of time, if Supreme Lord make you feel that the Rasa Leela is over within a fraction of second, then why he cannot show your eternal existence there in the transcendental jagat without any beginning of? Because we already know Sarupati Sabara Golokata Siti. Bhagavan going to prove everybody, all gopikas, they are going to discover that the Rasa Leela is over within fraction of second. How possible? They are expressing strong grief. Rasa Leela over within fraction of second. This way, what not possible? Madhaparambija Madhava Goswami very often used to speak this sloka. That which is kartum akartum annatha kartum ja samartaha sa iswara. Bhaktivala Tithasam also many times used to speak this sloka. Kartum akartum, what to do, what not to do, how to do, when to do, and how to make fool of you, all everything Bhagavan knows. No. Everything Bhagavan is omnipresent, omniscient, omnipresent, everything. So this way actually, it's not possible, we cannot say it is 100% possible. All contradictory factors can get full, get in all full and final adjustment, all proper adjustment, all contradictory points or factors can get all proper adjustment or full and final adjustment there in the transcendental abode, which is quite impossible here in this material world. Always try to remember this most vital point to avoid further complication. Though this Adyagantata Vastu is unique, one and a single, without any second. Still, this tattva vastu is full of infinity diversity. We should remember this point. We know very well that Sri Krishna is the original cause of all causes, anadi radhi govinda sarva karana karanam, eternally present there in Goloka Dhamma, then surely all these infinity diversity also eternally present there in Goloka Dhamma. And here also in material world. Sambhit Shakti, And that, you know, these three Shaktis are always there. These three Shaktis, Sambhit Shakti is there, Sandini Shakti there, and another Shakti is also there. Three Shaktis, you know, Ladini Shakti. All reflection, Ladini Shakti reflection coming here, I mean in the shadow world. The material world is the pervertic reflection of the transcendental world. Ladini Shakti reflection coming here. So material love affair, like man, woman, hero, heroine, all life affairs going to manifest. Ladini Shakti original there, but is a pervertic reflection. Distorted form of that Ladini Shakti. But still this kind of love affair is full of contamination, full of selfishness. Ladini Shakti. Sanghi Shakti, all scientists and philosophers, they are going, so many astronauts, they all, you know, they are going to play their brain, going to learn something, going to express something, writing books, expressing their knowledge, everything, all useless. Because after leaving this body, all useless. All scholarship, anything what you show here, all useless, next life. Next life. Follow. Again, cannot be there. So, actually, Ladini Shakti, Sambhik Shakti, all different kind of material education here available in this material world. All, be it scientific research or philosophical research, whatever you think, all coming from the Sambhi Shakti, originally there. They are originally Sambhi Shakti. That's why when somebody wanted to put question in front of Prabhupada, where from you are getting so many news, daily? Nadia Prakash, Hari Maharaj, where from you are getting so many news? Then Prabhupada giving answer, why not? Why not? Those material reporters, those material editors of the newspapers of different, you know, they are going to write countless news daily. Whereas this material world is one portion ekpad vibhuti. And all other there, tinpad vibhuti there. Oh, vast infinity world. Chit jagat. So you are going to manage so many news here in the material world. Why we cannot... So why you are going to express doubt in it? In Chit Jagat Infinity News, somebody is speaking, Prabhupada, where from you are getting so many news that you are daily, like daily newspaper you are expressing. Newspaper, oh, Nadia Prakash. Prabhupada, why not possible? Only you will have to get in connection with the transcendental world. Countless information can manifest inside your heart. You can get through some sadhu or this, that. Or at all any material thing you are thinking, you can take it in a positive way. Follow. Those who are sadhu, they are going to see something negative here, very dirty thing. Still they are going to take it positive way. Because their darshan power is Vaikuntha darshan. Their darshan is Vaikuntha darshan. Their darshan is Vaikuntha darshan. So, is possible? Why not possible? So, Ladini Shakti, all the perverted reflection of that Ladini Shakti going to express a shadow Shakti of Ladini, and that Shakti going to arrange love affair between each other in this material. Of course, if Atma is there, then the question of love coming. Atma Bahari Durshrava is okay, but still, love affair they are coming. And this kind of all material education in the material world, all coming from Sanghvit Shakti. Eternally there in Sanghvit Shakti, all knowledgeable personalities, big, you know, associates of Bhagavan, they are eternally present there. Here we can use this word erudite personality, erudite pandit, But there, actually they are eternally present. Big Pandit there. So all different kind of Sangeet relationship and sense of seva, everything in eternal world are manifested by this Samvit Shakti. Without Samvit Shakti, you cannot realize the love for relation. Follow. It's at the same time very effective. Here also in material world. And Sandini Shakti, by the help of Sandini Shakti, in the eternal world, I just told you, Balaji Maharaj is going to make eternal dham, everything. Are Maharaj, eternal dham is created by Balaram? Yes. When created, no question can be there. Eternally present, it. Though Balaram Maharaj creating, but still created by Balaram. But still, anadi, we cannot specifically say that this Mananta, this time, this Vaikuntha Jagat was created. Eternally present. Sahasavattam kavalam gokulaksham mahatpavam tatkarunikaram tat anantangsha sambhava. This all Dhamma, Golok Dhamma, Vaikuntha Dhamma, all different chambers there in Vaikuntha, all created by Sandini Shakti. Follow. If you can feel confusion that the Grihastha life of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Grihastha life of Sivas Pandit, Grihastha life of Sivananda Sen, all the same with me, it is a great blunder, big mistake. Actually, all the son and daughters of, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur or Sivananda Sen, Sivas Pandit, is coming from the Shakti, Sandini Shakti. Sandini Shakti Prakatito Nijajan. They are Sandini Shakti Prakatito Nijajan. Sandini Shakti going to express. So Kabi Karnapur or, you know, Sivananda Sen, all they. So it are, yeah, Sandini Shakti Prakatito. So this way, Ladini Sangvit Sandini, this, by all reflection, here in this material world, shadow, by Sandini Shakti, this body we find, given by Maya, a relationship, man and woman, this body, a son and daughter, father and mother, all different bodies, relationship. All material ingredients, whatever you are going to watch. All material ingredients, whatever we are going to watch, all the perverted reflection of that Sandini Shakti. Follow what I say. This way, we should have a fine conception about creation. We can see the jiva going to take birth, this, that. We are going to pass this kind of remark. So you see, this can be treated as diversity made by Sri Krishna himself as a mode of playing with all countless jivas. No other reason can be found. The option to choice was surely not there previous to this bondage condition. Because bondage condition is anadi, beginningless. Jiva's bondage is spontaneous, it is eternally present, and without any cause. Krishna, karma is literally anadi as manifested in the Vedanta Sutra, already I see. So, naturally, there was no first choice on the part of Jiva, originally. But now, when it was already Tatasa Jiva now going to travel, then in that case there can be choice. By the grouping, first, you know, Nitya Mukta, Nitya Bada, there is no choice. Nitya Bada, Nitya Bada, Nitya Mukta, Nitya Bada. Now, Nitya Bada, those who are Tatasa Jiva, they are coming from Balaram, I already told. Infinity Jivas, they have the option, they can choose. It depends. So what Baladev Vidyabhushan saying in Vedanta Sutta, actually Krishna Boli Seiji Anadi Varmu, all proper adjustment now we can find. There is no ambiguity, no fighting, nothing can stand. No problem can stand there. This way, we are going to think. Now we are going to discuss some special points about jivas. Everybody is speaking this word. Jive sarupai Krishna Nityadas, Jive sarupai Krishna Nityadas, Krishna Vali Seiji Manadi Bairmu, Atev Mayatari, Daya Sansara. We are hearing this point. Always and everybody is speaking the same. But nobody can realize this point. Except Vaishnava Dharma, everywhere philosophy means something which is imaginary. Or at all, if reality is there, it is mixed up with some imaginary conception. So philosophy, Bhagavad Dharma, or Vaishnava Dharma, or Eternal Dharma, or Atma Dharma, Jaiva Dharma. Philosophy means which is eternally truth. There is no contamination. No question of imagined manipulation, or no, you know, concocted idea, nothing can be there. From these words of Chaitanya Charitamrita, that Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das, Krishna Tatasya Shakti Vedavit Prakash. Analytical discussion we like to do again, though we are discussing for the past long time, but still we'll have to draw conclusion, because how Sarupa Jiva fixed and this kind of diversity where from coming, all we can prove under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Keshav Goswami, all. All we are going to discuss this point very energetically before Gaur Purnima period. Because we have not time. From the words of this Chaitanya Charitamrita, we see that eternal dharma of Jiva is to serve Krishna. Everybody is speaking. From these words, Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can see clearly that the eternal dharma of Jiva is to serve Krishna, nothing else. But practically, we cannot see it is in applied form. But practically, we cannot see it in applied form. Why? This is the question. Under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we are going to discuss. Actually, the service of Krishna, try to understand. Actually, the service of Krishna is not something. Actually, the service of Krishna is not something that you will have to practice or learn. This is not something which you can get from outside. It is not foreign element. You need not collect it from outside world. This is not something which you can get from outside world. Be sure about it. It is already there in the very sarupa of Jiva. Also, yesterday I was giving answer. Previously also I told many times that tatastha position of Jiva is resting in fine, very fine form, subtle form in the sarupa of Jiva. Actually, jiva is not at all tatastha. But tatastha position, tatastha feeling is there already. We know all countless examples you can see. It is not fictitious. It is there. I already told many times, and if situation demands, so I can again speak. This is not something Krishna Priti, I mean Jiva Sarva Krishna Chidas Krishna Tatastha Sakti Vedavit Prasa. This is not something which you can get from outside. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing that it is the very nature of the jiva. Because the jiva has a subtle spiritual form with face, eyes, nose, etc., everything. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Especially those who are in the line of Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like Rupa Goswami Pada, Sanatana Goswami Pada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gaur Kishore Babaji, Prabhupada, etc., they all have a special soul's body, I mean chit body, like a Brajavasi, a very sweet and beautiful teenage form. Of course, some of our Guru Varga, I heard, they got Siddhi in Sakkarasa. I don't like to mention their name because everybody like to jump into Madhur Rasa because they are already material Madhur Rasa is there. That's why they are fighting among themselves in Vrindavan, Puri. Oh, Madhur Rasa. Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj was a Sakkarasa Siddha. I know from Guru. I know it for sure. Mathura Baba, used to, long ago, he is the disciple of Prabhupada, all. So another big person, famous man, Acharya, is also Sakkarasa, but they are fighting among themselves. And what it concerns to you? He is Sakkarasa Siddha or Madhurasa? You think about, while your own machine, you try to have big fighting going on, foolish. They are less interested to give full protection to the Siddhanta Vani of this Sampradaya. Sampradaya going away. They are thinking about this, like child, they are fighting with this issue. If you have your power, you give full protection. Siddhanta Vani. Like Sahajiya, you are fighting. You have no attention. Sampradaya is totally in dilemma. Everybody busy with their personal matmandi, personal position. Foolish. So, Bhaktivinoda, so they have the chit sarup. Everything is there in the jiva, but externally you cannot see. The service of Krishna is not a religion. The service of Krishna is not a religion or faith at all. It is the dharma arising from the constitutional position of the jiva itself. Now question is that if it is quite natural with the jiva, then why this cannot be seen naturally with jiva? If it is quite natural with jiva, then we cannot see. If it is quite natural with jiva, then why this cannot be seen naturally with jiva? On the contrary, we see everybody, each and everybody busy with maya seva. Each and everybody, they are busy with maya seva. Externally, they are opening ones. Externally, they are going to open one seva, aprakita seva, exhibition. But internally, if you search, Ayurvedic doctor, Guru Vaishnava can arrest them. They are going to open one exhibition of seva. Oh, all seva going on. But it is not at all seva. It is one kind of business. It is business. It is business. It is business. Santo Goswami many times told, Kesava Goswami, all better. It is business. It's not, it is not, it is not running temple. It is not, you know, it is not maintaining temple. It is like business. Book selling is not so important. Book selling is not so important. We can see so many items like Sahajiya, Kirtan, Leela Kirtan by Matajis, which you can safely play in Pross Quarter. They are playing. They are going to display some outside material item. So they like to, they are interested about business. Books and a Maharaj, so how many people going to take books? This we are going to sell. Yes, we are going to make money. This way they cannot touch the lotus feet of Nrisimhadeva or Salgram. They cannot say that we are running a devotional organization, spiritual organization. Cannot say. They have no power. So, if at all it is quite natural with jiva, then why this is not, this cannot be seen naturally present with jiva? Even those who are practicing for long time, still they cannot even realize this point practically. Those who are practicing for 60 years in Gauriya Math, here, there, spiritual, but they cannot feel. If there is no realization, what Harikatha you can speak? Harikatha means realization. Harikatha doesn't mean you can memorize something and speak. Follow. And you are going to make mistake. You are going to make mistake. That Jiva Goswami was speaking, Aptobakko, you know, the speech coming out from the lotus mouth of pure Guru Vishnu. You should not express any doubt. Maybe Gaur Kishore Baba going to express in a different form, whereas Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda write to a different form, but it cannot be so that Gaur Kishore Baba going to make a mistake in. This means Siddhanta you are going to make mistake. Bhaktivinoda is speaking about a particular Siddhanta vichar. If a big sadhu realized soul, going to pass remark, who is staying in north pole of this world. And another sadhu who is staying in the south pole of this material world, if they both of them going to pass on remark about the same spiritual point, I am not speaking of a rasagata vichar, a spiritual point general, it cannot be different. Bhaktivinoda is all the same. So, Shabda Praman in Vedanta, if you start Vedanta, you can Shabda Praman and other different kind of Praman is there. Jiva Goswami is going to express this mood that Shabda Praman, Aprakita Shabda Brahma Praman is the topmost. Shabda Praman is topmost. But Apto Bhakko, I mean when Shastra Bhakko spoken by some sadhu is okay. When one sadhu is going to speak something out of his realization, be sure he is going to speak about Shastra Vichar. Because this kind of Vichar cannot come in his inside his heart, cannot appear, which is impractical. Follow. You can find in here and there, but one sadhu speaking, where is Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking? Where is written? If you meditate, then you can feel, this is written by Bhaktivinoda, you can feel. So many Tattva Siddhanta which are there. If you are busy with fighting, simply by argument, cannot stand. So now, we are going to, even those who are practicing for the long time prior, still they cannot even realize this point practically. This is our question. Why? Then how this can be called Jiva's natural and original dharma? Whereas we find that for a long time somebody going to practice, but still they cannot realize this point practically. Why? This is the question. Then how this can be called jiva's natural or spontaneous or original dharma? Bhakti is a natural or spontaneous dharma of jiva. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to explain under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We will have to understand this point. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given a wonderful solution to this question. His contradiction cannot stand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to give answer to this question. Also, many times our Kesava Goswami are speaking Vastu Shakti, the subtract of a substance. Vastu Shabhava, the nature of the substance is each and every Vastu, not one Vastu, any matter, each and every Vastu have a speciality, each and every. So, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given a nice, wonderful solution. Vastu Shakti and Vastu Shabhav. Vastu Shabhava, I mean the nature, subtract of the substance, can be found with any Vastu, any item. Follow. Any item. If you collect iron has some aluminium, if you like to collect, you can get some. If you want to get copper, you can get some. If you like to cotton cloth, if you're going to collect ice, water, all Vastu Shakti, Vastu nature. Like the example, water is quite natural, the liquidity of water is quite natural dharma. Liquidity of water is quite natural. The liquidity of milk is also quite natural, has some speciality. We cannot say that it is liquid and water is also liquid, so all the same, no. All each and every infinity object in this world, anywhere, Vastu Shabhava, nature, can be found with any Vastu. Substance attribute. Kesava Goswami also, he used to discuss this point very nicely because he was big pandit of Vedanta. Among all our Guru Varga is the Vedanta. Oh, so nice. So, substance attribute. The attribute of any substance exists with the substance itself. You need not hire from outside. The attribute of any substance exists with the substance itself. It cannot be separated at all. It cannot be separated at all. Follow. Every substance has shabhava, personal nature. Every substance has swabhava. Swabhava. Every substance has swabhava, personal nature, particular nature. That is called dharma of that substance. That is called dharma of that substance. That is called dharma of that substance. So Thakur writing that the very nature of the jiva, by the nature, I mean the dharma of jiva is called prema dharma. Prema dharma, you know. Follow. Thakur giving example, many times Thakur speaking. The very nature of jiva is called prema dharma. In Jiva Dharma also explaining. Follow. Thakur giving example that when a substance or vastu coming in contact with some separate energy or separate object, I mean another substance having some separate nature, then due to the influence of that substance, the object, I mean that substance, can undergo some vikar. Follow? Thakur giving example that when a substance or vastu coming in contact with some separate energy or another separate substance, then due to the influence of that substance, that object can undergo some vikara of transformation. So the original nature of the substance or the vastu object can be seen changed automatically. But surely the original nature of that vastu or substance is not lost, but at present cannot be seen, because that has gone to a latent stage at present, for the time being. So if we find some vikar, I mean change of one object in contact with other object or energy, external energy, like water, when we are going to apply heat energy, then water can go in the form of vapor. But vapor is not the original form of water, but still changed. So one object in contact with another object can change. Yes, possibility. But surely the original nature of that vastu, I mean the object, is not lost. It is not lost. Like the vapor, if you collect those vapors, you are giving heat from outside in the water pot, or vapors going out, you are having a scientific element like condenser. Those who are doing scientific research, they know this instrument, condenser. One closed glass bottle, silicon glass bottle. Borosil is more practical because can heat resistive. If you allow so many heat, but still the glass bottle cannot break. It's called borosil, borosilicate. Chemistry name is borosilicate. It's very nice. So you are putting some water, going to fix some cork, you know, cork means stopper. And you put one single outlet of glass, and that L-type glass outlet ultimately going to enter into the joint of a condenser. Condenser means the object you are boiling, that object can get vapor, can go in vaporized condition, can vaporize, and in vapor condition, and that vapor can go through a specific outlet given there inside condenser. There is some, you know, like web, some glass, you know, glass like, you know, there is some outlet, and you are going to pass cold water through the jacket of the condenser. Try to understand. Condenser means there is one jacket, big, and inside there is another outlet. So the main, you know, thing which is boiling, you are going to allow that, you know, boiled object to pass through in vapor form through that the inner outlet. I mean, there's a long pipeline. And outside jack of that pipeline, there is cold water. One cold water entering from the top and from the, you know, and extreme point, there cold water going out. These are all fresh water coming inside, cold water and fresh water again going outside. This way, due to cold water, effect of that cold water, those vapors which I allow to pass through this condenser, again I can find in droplets, again water can come back. If I am going to collect in a glass jar, I can collect. So this way we can change the form of water into vapor or ice. So Bhaktivinoda was speaking that you can find some change, external change in the nature of the substance, but surely the original nature of that substance or vastu is not lost at all. But at present cannot be seen, because that has gone to a latent state at present. I mean, for the time being. Srila Thakur going to give this example of water. Water is always liquid. It's quite natural. Water is always liquid under normal condition. Water is always liquid. By the liquid by nature. But if somehow we can allow a sub-zero level temperature, we can arrange a temperature, sub-zero level temperature, we can maintain temperature, then no more you can find the water in liquid form. Rather, this water can show a solid form called ice. It can show ice, solid form. If I throw ice on your head, you can break your head. So, you see, through this procedure, we can prove that the nature of the substance of the particular object is already there in latent form, not changed. Though the nature of water is naturally liquid, but still at present not showing this liquidity, at present showing solid form, without undergoing any reaction, automatically, because if reaction, then totally the substance can change. So without undergoing any reaction, automatically showing solidity. Water going to show solid form. So the nature of the water disappeared, and now as if a new spatial nature or character exhibiting. Follow what I say. So the nature of the water, liquidity disappeared, and now as if a new spatial nature exhibiting. Same way, when a jiva coming in contact with maya for a long time, anadikal, then the natural prema dharma naturally can go to a latent form, and that jiva can show mayamayi dharma, I mean, can show like ghost. When ghost going to enter body, pisachi paile jatha matichanna hai, pisachi paile jatha matichanna hai, mayabaddha jivera sevabudhahi. This kind of same nature you can. So naturally, then the natural prem dharma of a jiva naturally can go to a latent form, and that jiva now at present can show like a ghost, behavior, efficacy, character, all rubbish. Can show mayamayi dharma, mayamayi dharma. I mean, the dharma which is influenced by maya. And can think it is quite natural. It is quite natural. It is quite natural that they can think, all jiva. Because they are hypnotized by maya. This is called nisarga. Nisarga. At present this kind of condition, but not, it's not the eternal nature. This is called nisarga or adapted nature. This is called nisarga, Bhaktivinoda speaking. This is called nisarga or called adapted nature at present. So jiva by nature is the servant of Krishna, but due to the magic spell of maya, material energy, exhibiting this kind of aversive mood, nothing to do. Now when the foreign nature, I mean this maya, going to grasp the jiva, and all sukshma sarir and sula sarir, material body and subtle body, maya going to hypnotize and grasp over. Now when the foreign nature, I mean the maya, going to grasp the jiva, this automatically, because they automatically become busy with personal interest or enjoyment. I can again discuss this point. Next Harikatha I can try to touch. Again I will have to go to the, I will have to try to discuss about Nitya Sarupa, which is very important. All different Rupanuga Guru Varga going to pass remarks about this. Motir nakishne parato shatova mito vipadde to griho pradanan adanta govir vishatam tamisham punaha puno charvito charvananam vanchakalpa durvasya ke pasindhi bhavacha patitanan pavana bhavishna vyo namo.